Good afternoon. I'm Brian Abel. Here are your headlines from 7 Action News. Vice President Mike Pence back in Michigan today. This was his second trip to the Mitten in just over a week. The vice president hosting the Make America Great Again rally at Barnstormers in Waterford Township this afternoon. Pence's speech touched on the coronavirus pandemic, the economy, and the nomination of Judge Amy Coney Barrett to the Supreme Court. We have new information following a deadly shooting at Basketball City in Roseville. Police now say a valid CPL holder who fired the shots has been released from custody. 26-year-old Shaquan Harvey was killed at the gym on Tuesday night. Police say Harvey left after an altercation, returned with a gun, and pointed it at someone. That's when they say the CPL holder intervened, firing shots and killing Harvey. Smith Road Elementary School is temporarily closing its face-to-face programs after several people tested positive for COVID-19. Officials with the Bedford Public School District say three people inside the building are infected, as well as a fourth person who was a visitor at the school this week. They hope to reopen in-person instruction in 2 weeks on November 5th. Health experts are working with district leaders to follow contact tracing protocol. A piece of Detroit history is being honored today with the opening of a new park. Today was the grand opening for the new Fort Street Bridge Interpretive Park. It serves as a way to remember the old Fort Street Bridge, which was used during the Ford Hunger March protests in 1932. The Fort Rouge Gateway Coalition helped create the park, which includes a sculpture, rain garden, and walking path.
Across the area this afternoon, and temperatures will continue to warm right through the overnight until we hit the 70s for highs on Friday. By the afternoon and evening, scattered showers and storms, and that'll bring our temperatures back down into the 50s this coming weekend.